Hey Watercolor Wizards, Hajra here. Today I'll be adding some shimmer to fairy wings and showing you the best way to use an iridescent or pearlescent medium on your watercolor paintings. Art blogs, Q&As, sketches, deconstructed paintings, video notes, art gifts, and more rewards are available for my patrons on Patreon. So first off, you need a bottle of what's called iridescent or pearlescent or shimmer medium for watercolors. Daniel Smith and Winsor & Newton make this as well, and this one is from Schmincke, and they've called it Aquashine. Golden, Liquitex, and other brands also make iridescent mediums, but those are acrylic mediums, so be aware of that if you buy them. So I'm gonna shake up my Schmincke bottle, open it up, and get some off the lid. And I'm getting a little glass cup that I used for ink and actually turn it over. The bottom has a little recessed area that works as a paint well, and I'm just gonna add a dab of the shimmery medium to the well along with a dab of water. And here's a scrap of black paper to swatch the iridescent medium. Metallics and shimmery mica paints, due to their light reflective nature, all look their most vibrant on black paper. And you can see that I can apply the medium in a translucent glaze just to add sparkle and a pearly shimmer, or I can apply it thicker and it looks opaque, almost like a silvery metallic paint. The mica particles are floated in a gum arabic solution since this is for use with watercolor painting. So this is a resoluble solution and it can be re-wet and spread around to dilute it, and it also dries slower because of the humectant qualities of the water-soluble binder. This is good for watercolor painting as you can lift, correct, dilute, and not have to rush, but it does also result in some limitations as well. I'll talk about all this as I add this Aquashine medium to these fairy wings from a previous video project. I just want to use the iridescent medium as an accent on this painting, just on the wings for a translucent shimmer. You can't really see where I'm putting it now as this is a much lighter background than the black paper, but when I tilt it later you'll see it shimmer. And I'm going to be going around the small white gouache highlight areas as gouache lifts and streaks if you glaze over it, so I'll be avoiding those little areas. If you want to use this to add shimmer to a watercolor piece with gouache highlights, don't use it over the gouache highlight areas, and if you want to use it with a full-out gouache painting, then mix it into your gouache pigmented paints and apply it while you are painting the actual paint colors. And you'll only have to use a little bit as it's very concentrated, and you can see I'm working with just a dab or two here for the whole wings area. If you want more shimmer, you can always add more medium, but you don't want it to just take over by adding too much. You can do the same thing with watercolor paintings, mix a bit of the shimmery medium into pigmented paint on a palette and make the paint itself shimmery and just paint with that. Make sure you only do this mixing on a palette and not in your pans, otherwise you will ruin your pan paints by contaminating them with shimmery mica particles, and then add some iridescent medium to that paint on your palette to get a colored pearlescent paint. The further limitations with working with this medium are that mica lifts off and scoots around very easily because it's a shimmery mineral and not as fine as the pigment powders, and this means it won't layer well. So I suggest that if you mix this into your color paints, whether watercolor or gouache, use it as a single layer or one or two loose layers max. And I actually feel the best way to use this iridescent medium with water-soluble paints is just to use it last, like I am here. That way I can apply it over previously dried and detailed layered conventional paint glazes, whether in accent areas, the background, or the whole piece, and the rendering work for the watercolor painting is already done and locked into the paper and won't budge if you use a light hand with the shimmer medium and semi-staining or staining pigments earlier. Now if I'd mixed this into the colors and tried to paint the wings like they look, I wouldn't have been able to achieve the fine layered glazes that I have, as the mica bits would just keep scooting and lifting and cause a lot of frustration as I try to render with the paint. So even though it says you can mix it into colors, unless it's a loose layer or two, using the iridescent medium last and by itself, not mixed into any paint, will be the best way to use it for me. Even when this Aquashine medium is dry and used transparently, the mica in the pearlescent or iridescent medium will rub off in your finger or other things just a bit, and that includes a scanner bed if you scan your art. And it's not much, but if this mica shedding is a concern, then you can seal over the mica areas with a spray sealer like SpectraFix if you are okay spraying the whole watercolor piece, or seal portions with a brush-on sealer. Since I have it around, I can also use transparent watercolor ground mixed into this iridescent medium when I apply it, or use that transparent watercolor ground as a top coat sealer. You can also use Liquitex acrylic matte medium the same way if you have it, or even a matte finish pH neutral glue. All of these options will keep any of that mica from shedding anywhere. This also means you can just buy an iridescent, pearlescent, or shimmer medium made for acrylics or something else waterproof to begin with. Then you can mix it into your pigmented acrylic paints and apply it whenever, since it'll dry permanent and not lift. And you can also use those acrylic iridescent mediums over a watercolor painting in accent areas, but you'd still have to use it last as you won't be able to watercolor further over that area. And keep in mind that your artwork will no longer be a traditional watercolor painting, it'll be mixed media, which is fine, but you may not want that. Well, wizards, hope this helped you understand how to make the best use of iridescent, pearlescent, or shimmer mediums. Please like, comment, subscribe, and check out my website links and Patreon page to support my art and art channel below. Thanks for parking your brushes here and wishing you all sparkly painting adventures.